Branded one of the country's most corrupt cops, convicted murderer Roger Rogerson has died. His meteoric rise during the 70s and 80s came during the height of police corruption in our state. The disgraced detective's death marking the end of an era.
Roger Rogerson, crooked cop, the dodger, disgraced former New South Wales detective. But when the end came, there was no name. In a brief statement, corrective services announced an 83-year-old inmate has died at Prince of Wales Hospital on Sunday, 21 January 2024. Rogerson, unlikely to be missed, but never forgotten.
There are people who believe that I'm the most corrupt, wicked, diabolical person in the world. I can never change their mind.
And he was right. Former police officer and author Duncan McNabb.
He's always been called the most notorious copper in New South Wales. I think he's well beaten. The guy's competent and incredibly corrupt. I haven't seen a copper of his calibre, for all the wrong reasons, anywhere.
And then there was Rogerson's solicitor of 15 years, Paul Kenny.
Just very normal, very quiet. And he never spoke about anything in the police that he'd done with me ever. Not one word, and with me he's quite okay. I never had any problems with him.
In fact, in the early years of Rogerson's career, he was a pin-up. Decorated for locking up crooks, he had high expectations.
This bloke could be the head of the CIB someday, or maybe even commissioner.
But his fearsome reputation brought him undone. Rogerson shooting dead three people in the line of duty, including drug dealer Warren Lanfranchi in a Chippendale laneway in 1981.
I said, this bloke's going to shoot me. I knew he was going to pull the trigger. So I've fired twice. And he's fallen over and he's landed in the gutter. I don't really regret it. I regret what happened as a result of shooting him.
Notorious criminals became partners in crime, Nettie Smith and Graham Henry. The latter today telling Nine News, Rogerson was charismatic and charming, but he didn't have much of a conscience. He helped me and then he on me.
Did you ever ask anyone whether he'd actually killed anyone or had given the green light for robberies?
No.
But Rogerson's life of crime was portrayed in the miniseries Blue Murder.
Best crook I've ever seen, mate.
Don't you ever say that to me again.
In 2014, a real-life video sealed his fate. CCTV captured the murder of drug dealer Jamie Gow.
Did you kill Jamie Gow?
Solicitor, I'm saying nothing.
Rogerson's lawyer was present when police pounced.
They all surrounded him. If they had the opportunity, they would have put five sets of handcuffs on him.
A life sentence became a death sentence. The 83-year-old suffered a brain aneurysm last week and passed away last night. Condolences have been few and far between.
It was a lifetime of, in many cases, dishonour to the New South Wales Police Force. I don't have anything further to say about him.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.
And Damien's with me in the studio now. Damien, it appears Rogerson will take to his grave the answers to a number of unsolved murders.
That's exactly right, Pete. It's been revealed police hoped to extract that deathbed confession from the corrupt officer negotiating access to him in the Long Bay jail as his health deteriorated. But there was never any face-to-face meeting with him. So it's suspected Rogerson may have known what happened to missing hitman Christopher Dale Flannery and several others who vanished in the 80s when Rogerson was certainly calling the shots. Now, of course, because Rogerson died in custody, his death will be investigated by the coroner, Pete.
Damo, thank you.